This video contains spoilers of the Quintessential Quintuplets anime and manga. If you have not caught up or do not wish to be spoiled, go ahead and watch and read them now. Go ahead. I'll wait. I'm still here. Ooh, I'm gonna make a sandwich. Welcome everyone to an in-depth look at the Quintessential Quintuplets. I will be your captain of these fine five ships as we travel through treacherous waters. If you've been living under a rock for the past few months, the Quintessential Quintuplets is an anime that has turned the harem world on their heads, mainly due to its wholesomeness. Anyway, Quintessential Quintuplets starts out as a wedding of Futaro and his bride. It's a series of flashbacks about Futaro and the five girls he agrees, rather reluctantly, to tutor. Well, it turns out that these girls are quintuplets, and they aren't just dumb. No, these girls are complete idiots. They fail all their classes, and yet Futaro sees a little light in each of them. This starts a series of events resulting in drugging, blaming, smacking, and pure humor. You know, all those things you look for in life. And while the show is perfect in every way, there's just one thing on everyone's mind. The question of, who is Futaro's bride? This question has sparked many conversations online. Ships have been built, my friends, and they have set sail, dividing them among the empires of Ichika, Nino, Miku, Yotsuba, and Itsuki. Each girl is making a run at being the bride, and each one makes her case. Okay, now all that is over, let's look into who might be the bride. As far as the anime goes, Yotsuba is the first one to show any sign of liking Futaro. After a series of events, Miku develops feelings too. In one of the most intriguing arcs in anime. Over time, we find that Itsuki and Ichika have also developed the same feelings. And that just leaves Nino. You know what? We'll get back to her later. Now, we're told that the bride held hands with Futaro at the end of the bonfire dance, and as we can see, they all held his hand, or at least a finger. This is a sign that maybe all of the girls have a chance. This is basically where the anime ended, and, well, my score is Miku, Ichika, Yotsuba, Itsuki, and Nino. I mean, this sounds about right. I mean, why would Nino ever be in competition? She is clearly a horrible tsundere with nothing going for her. She has never proved herself to be a good choice for the position of waifu. At least that's what I thought. And thus, we continue into the manga. So let's get into the good parts. We'll skip right before the scrambled eggs chapters, because anything before that is all character development. Look, this sets off like 9 chapters, but look what I found, okay? On the winner chart, when Miku and Futaro go into the same sort of, I don't know what they call it, a store. Yeah, that word. There's something interesting. Now let's go through them. Pocket tissue. God, I hope it's not used. Gift catalog. Oh, that's intriguing. It's like Sears. Gift voucher. 3,000 yen. Hey, that's not pretty bad. Rice. 5 kilograms. Don't know why that's a higher thing than the vouchers. And the main prize is a pair of hot spring tickets. And look at this. B prize. Pair of rings. How many? 5. That's right. 5 rings. Now, this does not confirm anything, okay? I'm not saying that there's going to even be a chance at a harem ending, because we've already been swayed off from that. See, we know that Miku knows about the receipt prize thing, right? And we know that Futaro won the onsen prize, but did Miku win that prize as well? Because we know that their grandfather owns the onsen, so I'd not be surprised if they just, you know, scheduled a vacation at the same time. Because Miku never says something like, you know, I'm so glad I won this prize. I may have read something wrong, okay? Somebody's going to fact check me on this, but I swear to God that she never mentions what she won. But even if she did win the prize, those rings are important, okay? I just want everybody to see that. Now we know that all the girls are dressing as Itsuki for Grandpa, and we know the girl who tells Futaro that she doesn't want him to be their tutor anymore is Miku. She did this trying to say, I want to be more. But she is, not, she can't say it to him as herself. But Ichika, the frickin' troll, pretends to be Miku and tells Futaro she's rooting for whoever he chooses. This girl's out of her mind, I swear, and she's playing dirty, even after Miku wanted to play fair. And I'll admit, okay, all's fair in love and war, but come on, is Futaro really worth destroying your sisterhood over? Huh. Apparently. As we see the bride supposedly kiss Futaro under the bell of vows, and Futaro does not know who she is because she was dressed as Itsuki. Prior to that, Nino and Ichika have a conversation about just outright kissing Futaro, so we're led to believe that it is one of them two. It is further analyzed where Futaro looks at Ichika's lips and says something about how he has no idea why she did that. Look, at this point, my lineup is Miku, Nino, Yotsuba, Itsuki, and Ichika. I'm so done with Ichika, and you know what? Itsuki can only get to Futaro if she's dressed as Rena. Nino has impressively jumped up the scale. I am so proud of her, with her dedication to everyone and just outright telling Futaro she loves him. I mean, that takes some freaking balls, dude. Alright, so we move on to the most recent chapters, where they're on the school trip in the place where Futaro first met Rena, who we still don't know at this point if it's really Itsuki or not. Now, we see that the girls and Futaro have split up into different groups, and surprise, surprise, Ichika is dressed as Miku to sabotage her. This backfires because Miku sees the doppelganger and knows it is Ichika. Miku, precious perfect angel that she is, thinks Ichika has a good reason for this. She even asks her. Yotsuba, with her big mouth, yells that Miku wants to confess to Futaro. Right as Futaro shows up, I swear to God, we're getting into domestic girlfriend levels of showing up at the wrong time. Y'all better close your doors, okay? Yotsuba and Futaro end up looking for Miku, and he and Yotsuba had a really heart-to-heart moment, and he said that he knew Miku had feelings for him. We even find out there is no harem ending, because Yotsuba even mentions that Futaro will have to choose at some point that not everyone can win. So, that's where Chapter 82 closed. But Chapter 83 was a bit of a turning point. You see, Futaro figured out Ichika is dressing as Miku, and he just lost all trust and faith in her. And what's the one thing she said at the beginning? You know, you can always trust and come to your one-san if you need any help. She betrayed the trust of everyone. She went behind everyone's back, and she played dirty tricks, and even Miku saying she was sorry. She has nothing to apologize for, but she's just so apologetic for some reason. And we kind of end right before the first date of Miku and Futaro. Hey everyone, just a quick interjection here. I did read Chapter 84 post-roll, and might I say, wow, okay, I should have probably had some bread before I made this video. That's all I'm going to say, okay? That's all I'm going to say. Y'all go read it. It's hilarious. It's awesome. And you'll enjoy it. Or it'll toy with your heart like it did mine. Either way, I hope y'all are enjoying the video. Thank y'all for watching this far. Now back to our regular scheduled program. So that's where we are. Now, to the moment you all want to know, who is the freaking bride? Chill, okay? I'm getting to that. Very recently, I read an astounding analysis of the quintessential quintuplets that looks super in-depth about who the bride might be. And I'd love to give this person credit, but they didn't put a username or anything on their paper. Come on, that's like kindergarten level stuff. They tell you to do that first thing when you step in the door. This is what it looks like. If you are out there watching this, or if you know who made this, thank you for your insight. It was really helpful for making this video. I'll leave a link to where I found it in the description, okay? But it's really long. Lucky for you, I'm here to give you the highlights. So the analyst looks over every single angle you could think of. Starting with a visual perspective, the bride is obviously one of the quintuplets. Really, Sherlock? Looking at the bride up close, it becomes even harder to tell. According to the manga, the marriage is happening approximately 2 years ahead of where we currently are. As such, any of the girls' hairstyles could have changed. I mean, looks aside, the bride is very shy, very mellow, very melancholy. She seems to speak with a soft tone. I mean, of course, what wife doesn't on her wedding day, right? Now, going back to the scrambled eggs portion, the article writer found something interesting in the way they clenched their hands. Take a look at this math problem that the writer made. As we can see, Miku imagining a kiss for Taro, plus Isky disguise, carry the 2, subtract for pi factor in the quadratic formula, and we get, boom, a perfect match. Irrefutable proof that Miku is the bride. Time to wrap it up. Let's go. Time to go home. Wait for me. Oh, wait. Hang on. That doesn't prove anything. As we can see from this algebra problem, it seems that Miku has the upper hand. But let's look at it from a narrative perspective. Negi has said he hopes to write an ending the majority of people will be happy with. As Futaro is moving from his original character into one that sees more than just grades, he's changing like a butterfly. Why is this important, though? Why does this have such a big factor in it? Well, you see, we know that Futaro has developed feelings for his bride, and not just immediately fall in love with her. I mentioned that Futaro knows that Miku had feelings for him, and at that point, he might have discovered that maybe he was developing feelings too. I mean, of course, it's fair to say that every girl has a chance too by that analysis, mainly because at this point he knows that Ichika, Nino, and Miku have feelings for him. Nino just outright said it, and that was pretty amazing, and pulled a, I know you don't love me now, but over time you will, kind of scary yandere style. Maybe this is a sign that that was the moment she started a little spark in Futaro. The wording in this manga is crucial to finding out Futaro's feelings. You see, we're having a hard time figuring out who the bride is because we're watching a man slowly fall in love. That's why it's so hard to say yes or no to any of them, because the only signs are his changing emotions. Futaro doesn't even know yet, so how should we be able to? You get what I'm saying, right? Negi created these 5 girls and is just letting the story go on its own. It's created as it's going. There was no set blueprints for this thing. And that's why we can't figure out a pattern here. Now, calming down. Okay, so all signs are indeed pointing to Miku. And it is all in Futaro's reaction to events involving Miku. But why? Why is this one girl having such a dramatic change in his personality more than the others? Well, looking at the other girls, Itsuki would be the obvious choice because she is the first girl. There are many of these in anime. Her. Definitely her. Oh god, don't remind me. Negi has made fun of the first girl is the girl manga scenario, so I don't think she's the one. She also has put very little effort into trying to be with Futaro. She can only talk to him normally as Rena. Now Yotsuba reminds me of the girl next door childhood best friend who never wins, that kind of plight. I mean, example A, B, and Chiwa. That was a hard one. Ichika. Yeah, you know what? Forget Ichika. Go eat a boat, Ichika. And then we have Nino. The tsundere who wants to win the heart of the main character has a good chance considering her place. And considering how well she's developed in the manga, I'm just so proud of her. Anyway, in this Nisekoi-style anime of Who Is It?, we're left to decide for ourselves, who is the main girl? Is it not obvious? No? Don't you see? It's Miku. Miku's the main girl. The effort Miku puts in every day, she's pushing herself to win Futaro's heart. She put everything into getting better grades and was the first one to be on board with him being their tutor. Even now, she's trying to make perfect bread to show Futaro that she can learn to do anything. All this to say that she's not trying to beat the other 4 girls. She's just trying to be with Futaro. And that says a lot. Miku does something that goes above and beyond to prove everything. And while at times it may seem like she's going a bit overboard, keep in mind, she has to. The article I mentioned makes a great point. A harem girl has to do one thing in order to win the heart of the main character. She has to earn it. Earn is the main key word of the day. Miku has shown she will stop at nothing to earn Futaro's love, and she'll show it in any way she can. I mean, honestly, that's the only way one of the girls could. Looking at Futaro, he's a guy who earns every grade he gets. He works hard, dedicating his time and energy solely to the betterment of his grades. He seems to slowly be piecing together the fact that Miku is working with the same dedication for one very important reason. To win his heart. We have all played right into Negi's trap, I swear. He's making us feel the way he wants us to feel. Making Nino an unbearable unbearable tsundere into a loving, supporting sister and possible bride. And dang it, if she hasn't grown on me. And Ichika, the girl I trusted from day one, only to get stabbed in the back by her dirty tricks. She's not earning his love. She's making it so she looks like the only option. So with all that, who is the bride? Well, in my humble opinion, I cannot think of any reason why the bride is none other than Kaiki Deshu!
Yay!
Oh wait, hang on, that's... here it is, Miku. Yes, Miku is the bride. It's always been Miku. Miku has ascended to the level of not just waifu, but wife. I have always been a member of the Church of Miku, and honestly, now more than ever, I am certain that Miku is the best of girls. I mean, of course, we haven't finished the series yet. Negi could lead us down another path whenever he wants, and we, being the sheep that we are, will follow happily. While Miku is my favorite, I have to play devil's advocate and think, what if it's not Miku? Well, if the bride is Yotsuba, I would not be upset. I mean, honestly, I don't think any of us would be upset. Yotsuba shows true potential to be what I call a slipstreamer. She'll catch up and come from behind to finish in first place. Nino seems like she can win anything she puts her mind to and has earned my trust and respect. Isuki is just too basic for my taste, and I honestly don't think she is the bride. And that leaves Ichika. Okay, look, all jokes aside, Ichika had potential to be the bride. She was my number two. But what keeps me from saying yes is that she showed her true colors. She showed that she could not be trusted, and even Futaro said, I'm done with this, you know what? I can't trust you right now, I'm sorry. And just left her out in the cold rain. Ichika has left a bitter aftertaste in my mouth, and it's going to be hard for her to make that up. It's hard to sum it up, really. I mean, we have hit a turning point in the manga, and there's still much of the story that can happen. There's lots that can change our thoughts and our feelings. But I mean, come on, how is it not Miku? When is the best girl ever lost? Oh, well, yeah, I mean, her, but I mean, okay, yes, her. Okay, yes, her. Oh my god, my heart! Thank y'all so much for watching. I absolutely love the quintessential quintuplets, and I loved making this video. It was the first anime that made me want to read the manga and make a video analysis, actually. I can't wait to see where the manga goes from here, and if the anime gets a season 2. It's going to be so exciting. I want to send a big thank you to everyone.